Hello! Today we will be discussing how to solve some problems with the slow type tool in InDesign CS6. We will be taking a closer look at cross-references in book documents that can cause some problems, and also at GREP styles that are embedded in your paragraph styles. They can also cause some trouble. Also, you can check out the first part of this video here, where I will give you additional tips that might solve your problem if those in this video do not work. I have here my master thesis, and I encountered a problem with cross-references. Let's take a look. I open one document here, and you notice right away it has some problems while loading. It's kind of slow, but if we go into the text and we try to type something, you notice it's very sluggish. The reason for that are the cross-references. We can see here we have quite a lot of cross-references, but the number is not the problem. The problem is that some of these cross-references are actually linking to other pages. So as we type, InDesign is checking back with the other documents and doing something with the cross-references. So to solve the problem here, we're just going to open the documents that our cross-references in this document here, Material and Results, are linking to. So if we open the other documents here, InDesign does not have this problem any longer. So if we type now, you see it's very quick how it should be. So if you have a document that includes cross-references to other documents, make sure to have the other documents open as well. The next problem can be caused by GREP styles. Those can do formatting automatically, and I have already a video about this that explains you how GREP styles are working. In this case, I have one on my website which will do the formatting for my references. I'm going to copy this one from our website and put it into the basic text we are using. So the paragraph style for our complete text, you see I have quite some text in here. And I'm now going to go to the paragraph style basic text and just add the formatting in GREP style over here. I will apply a red background for the text so you can see it better. You see now I have included all the GREP styles that will do my formatting. And it's actually quite complicated. And InDesign now needs to check every time I type in here if the GREP style is fulfilled for all the text boxes. So if I type again now, you see it's again kind of sluggish and slow. Let's remove the GREP styles again from our basic text. We're going to delete all of them. Click on OK. And now the trick is to do the formatting with GREP styles with the replace and find function. So by pressing Command F, you can open your find dialog. And then here, I'm going onto the GREP panel, and I would go to the website and copy some formatting from here. I go back to InDesign and paste this into here. Now I apply this to all documents, and I could also limit this just to our basic text and not to other paragraph styles. And we're going to change the format of the things that match our GREP in here. And we change the format again to red so you can see the effect. Click on OK. And now we can test that one and click on Find. And you see here it has already found some of them. So we could now go on Change All. And now we see the formatting was applied automatically to all the references. Of course, you would need to use the other GREP styles on my website as well to get the complete formatting done. So if you're finished with writing your thesis, you can just apply the formatting to all your references like this pretty easily, without InDesign having to check all the time while you're typing if the GREP style is still matched. Personally, I think both problems here with the cross-references and the GREP styles is kind of a little bit bad implemented into InDesign, and I hope it will be changed with future versions of the Creative Suite.
Alright, I hope you found these tips helpful. Until next time, bye bye.